TVs here. But one's a computer one, actually. Gotta make sure they're all there. They're not been stripped out. I think this one's... I don't grab TVs, but it's in my area, so it's not so bad. I'll strip them down a bit. Their palms are so heavy. I'll strip them down and then recycle it after. The big one might be too heavy, actually. This compact one could be good. The copper, anyways. You don't see those too often. This is buried in snow yesterday, so it's melted. Quite a bit melted. That's a heavy one. Oof. I'll take the yolks off and maybe a couple things out of it and I'll recycle it. Not really worth it, but at least it's close to my house. Okay. Oh, this is kind of cool. That's kind of cool. Might be a reset button for that one. Have to find out. Try to loosen the load a little bit. Probably not stainless. Too late. And check. I lost my magnet. It's only about just a handle. Wire. Okay, well, not bad for coming back from the recycle center. So I think maybe I'm gonna do some wire. Gonna plug it in first. Still actually pretty cold. Thought it'd be a little bit warmer today, but it's still pretty cold. See the way it's all twisted here, it's a bit of a nightmare.
see how it goes. That's a noisy sounding. This wire doesn't really add up, it takes a lot before you have any weights. Since the price has dropped a bit, I think I'll just start to strip a little bit. See, being like all twisted and tangled, sometimes it doesn't want to cut right away. Coming off the roller. Oof, tough. May have to adjust the roller a bit. Might be out a bit. This thing will go through it all. Yeah, the roller might not be tightened. I had a jam last time, so I was playing with it. May have wrecked the setting up or something.
Thank you.
So all kinds of wire here. Another container. It's kind of hard to see after it gets all mixed up. We got a lot of short wires here. This is actually a pretty thick gauge. I don't know if it's 12 gauge, but it's pretty thick, thicker than the other stuff. This stuff is from when I got that pickup I did. So most of this wire is more up there. So it's just cooked already. The nice thing about this wire stripper, it just strips it all nicely right off the wire or the insulation. stripped. You can see it's pretty fast, the machine. Okay. And we have the rounded stuff here too. Try that next. That's the problem. Made it a little too tight. Holy smokes. Jam below or something. That's a problem. Different wire. Things jam differently, right? It's always something. I think it would go a little higher. Nope. You gotta watch out, spring sometimes, spring falls out. If you get a hammer maybe. I made it too tight last time, and then you get the wrong hole, and that's what happens. That's a big spaghetti twist in there. See all this here. A screwdriver or something. See, it rolled over. That's the problem. A jam here or something. jammed in there. That's what happened. Might have had some insulation jammed. That little small one may have wrapped around there, jammed in there. And then when I put this thing in there, jammed again, even more, possibly. Hard to say. But what happens is this over derails, right? And then your plastic is hard to get off. The problem, these strippers are not perfect. You gotta tinker with them a bit here and there. And they kinda get better after, but it's okay, it's working fine. Okay, I'm gonna put these through here, get them ready. Okay. A big handful here, I'm gonna feed that through, and then we're gonna see what kind of weight we have there.
Thank you.
Okay, so that is done. I'll just sit down here and then just pull wires, I guess. Pull my wire. He said his stuff is a lot thicker than the other stuff. It's gonna take a lot to make any decent weight. Need that really thick stuff to add up. I don't know what the prices are. I mean, it was $4.73 last time I checked for number two. Number one should be about $5, so I think. Or bright and shiny. Bear braid, or what do you want to call it? Nice thing about this, I don't have to, you know, once I take it out of the spool of, you know, how there's three conductors, I don't have to, you know, do too much. It strips it all really good. I don't have to worry about derailing. So I'm happy with that. Let me just finish this up here and we'll just see if we got any weight here at all. Okay. There's lots of waste there for just a little bit of wire. So we're gonna see. Two point seven, 2.8. Okay. 4.9 pounds. So like almost 25 bucks maybe, some of that. So not bad. Actually, pretty shine here. Well, I kept it sitting here for the number one pile because I know if I strip my wire, I'll have more over here also. $5.4 right now, not too bad. $5.4. Okay, so I keep stripping more. See what weight we get. Okay. So I took a yellow roll and I cut it into about 3 foot lengths. But the problem, the wire looped around. It went right through and around. This one went through here. I think I have to. This one looped right around the roller, which doesn't normally do that, but it's always something, right? This one went through that way. That's why when you get jam, it just gets stuck. Again. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna clean this up here, and then I'm gonna go through next stripping session here. Okay, so I'm gonna feed this through here. A lot of waste. The yellow stuff's very heavy. The outer jacket. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna clean this and weigh it. That's all waste. Here's copper. Not sure how heavy it is, but buck is just around 3. Maybe 15 pounds, I don't know. Could even be 20 pounds. Yeah, 14.3 pounds. So that's what, 54 times 5 is 70 bucks, maybe? 70? So not crazy amounts, but. It takes a lot to add up. I kind of like to set something up here, but last time I stupid things seized up, kind of worried about that. I'll try sideways or something. Some pretty thin stuff here. We'll try. Looks like it's pretty thin stuff. Wow, it's not even bright and shiny. It's not good. Tin coated. Crappy. Number 2. That's a bummer. I think the last one was burnt the same. That's a bummer. Seems where he wants to twist. I'm gonna finish this row off. I'm gonna weigh that row to see exactly how much was there. Okay. Full bucket almost. A little handful of copper here. It's tinted. Tinned or whatever you call it. £8 only. Or £9. It's tough for the stupid thing there. So 9.7, 9¾. That'll be number two. And this is number two I have here. So let's just be together. It's 2 pounds here. So I got 20 pounds. So 20 pounds, yeah, even. So 18 pounds, that's not bad. And then I have a little bit more here. I got all these little transformers to pick apart. Number two. Take off, say 4 pounds, 20 pounds, at least 21 pounds. I'll probably take it back tomorrow. We'll see. Still have a little more copper, but maybe Saturday for sure. Okay, I think that's it for the video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe, share, like, as always. Have a great day.